Welcome back to Wanderlust Yoga. I am Mrs. Wanderlust 16. Thank you so much for joining me today here in Memphis, Tennessee. I hope you all have had an amazing week since our last time meeting. Today's location, I was actually here 30 years ago. My mother brought me here in 1988. It wasn't then what it is now, but I do remember being here and it's pretty remarkable what it's become. So let me flip this thing around and show you where we are. So today we are here at the National Civil Rights Museum, formerly known as the Lorraine Motel. The museum guides visitors through 5 centuries of history, which traces the civil rights movement here in the United States. The museum houses an abundance of artifacts, films, interactive media, and oral histories. The Lorraine Motel is the location of Dr. Martin Luther King's assassination on April 4th of 1968. That day his life was claimed, altered the course of a movement, and changed history forever. Dr. King had a philosophy of nonviolence, which focused on peaceful demonstrations, acting with love, and calm. His philosophy was sparked by a 1950 lecture on the great Indian activist Gandhi. Right across the way from the Lorraine building is the Legacy building, which highlights milestone events that have shaped the civil rights climate over the years and how the movement currently continues worldwide. After our yoga today, we will be visiting inside of the National Civil Rights Museum. Just want to show you guys a couple things. I do encourage you to come visit the museum on your own. There's so much to learn, so much to see, so many artifacts that you have to experience for yourself. But I will be showing you a little bit. For now, I will meet you guys on the mat. All right, everyone, let's start at the back of our mats. And we're just gonna hold still for a moment in our mountain pose. Let's go ahead and close those eyes. Focus on your breathing. Take those deep inhales. Those peaceful exhales. Let's try to clear our minds. Just be still in this moment with me. And just breathe and relax. I have to say that yoga has been very healing to me with personal painful things that I've had to experience. And I encourage you all to allow yoga to help you deal with your experiences that you're healing from as well. Let's take a few more deep breaths here. Go ahead and raise those hands up high to your tall mountain. Look up to the sky. Stretch those hands up as far to the sky as you can. Go ahead and gently grab your left wrist and let's pull to the right just a bit. And let's go ahead and pull our right wrist to the left, just a bit. And let's go ahead for a slight back bend. One more time to our right. And another time to our left. Now, as we swing our arms down, we're also going to fold down into like a chair pose. So we're gonna do like a swinging chair motion. So go ahead and let yourself down slowly and swing those arms back and back up. and back down and back up. Back down and back up. And we're gonna do one more. Go ahead and swing those arms and back up. I'll meet you down in our forward fold, or actually our flat back. And now we will go down to our forward fold. Go ahead and walk yourself into a plank. And let's hold, just breathe. Let yourself down very slowly. Go ahead and kick those feet back. You can either raise yourself into a cobra or all the way up to your upward dog and hold. Go ahead and flip those feet over into your downward dog. Make sure your feet are flat, your hands are firm, those hips to the sky. Go ahead and kick that right foot forward. We're gonna hang out in our high lunge at the moment and just raise that right arm as high as you can. Look up to the sky. And back down. Release that foot back to our downward dog. Go ahead and kick that left foot forward. And let's bring our left hand high to the sky. And go ahead and release your hand back down, back into your down dog. And go ahead and walk your hands back to your feet into our forward fold. Back to your flat back. And back to your mountain. Now we're gonna go ahead back into that swinging chair motion that we did a few moments ago. So go ahead and bring your hands high. This time I want you to lift your heels as well. As high as you can go and as sturdy as you can be. Let's go ahead and do 5 of those swinging motions that we did. So bend those knees down, swing those arms back, and back up. Down, back up. Down, back up. Back down, and back up. And we're gonna go for one more. Back down and back up. Go ahead and relax your heels and relax your hands. And go ahead and stretch that out a bit. All right, back into our forward fold. And back into our plank. And let's just take a few moments here and breathe. Go ahead and let your knees down into our child's pose. And back up into our tabletop. Your hands should be under your shoulders. And let's go ahead and lift our right foot back and I will meet you down for 3 push-ups. That was 1. And 2. And 3. Let's go ahead and switch sides. Kick that left foot back. And down for 3. And relax. Back into your child's pose. And back into your tabletop. We're gonna do our little push-up routine one more time. So kick that right foot back and down for 3. And switch sides. And relax. And just breathe. Go ahead and lift those hips into your down dog. Go ahead and kick that right foot forward. Drop that back foot into our warrior 1. And extend out into your warrior 2. And go ahead to your reverse warrior. And let's fold forward. Back into your warrior 1. Now let's go ahead and lift our heels up. I gotta back up a little bit. Lift those heels up, hands high. I just want you to tilt forward and swing those arms. Tilt forward. And swing. We're gonna go for 3 more times. Go ahead and tilt. And 1 more time. And relax that heel. I'll meet you down back on our mat in our downward dog. Go ahead and kick that left foot forward. Drop that back foot. Warrior 1. And our warrior 2. And reverse. And forward. Go ahead back to warrior 1 and lift that heel up. Go ahead and tilt forward and swing. Go ahead and tilt. And tilt. And we've got 2 more. And release that heel. Release your hands. Back into your down dog. Go ahead and take a few moments to breathe. Stretch out that spine of yours, those hamstrings, those shoulders. And just breathe. Let's go ahead and walk our hands back into our forward fold, into our flat back, and back to our mountain. Now let's go ahead and get into our tree pose. So once again, you can be on your ankle, you can be on your calf, you can be on the inside of your thigh, or you can cross over. I'm slippery as usual, so I'm gonna hang out on the inside of my thigh. Make sure your legs stay straight. Bring your hands heart center and just hold. Now you can keep your hands where they are, or you can spread your branches with me. And you can also tilt over to your right. Rest that right hand on your thigh and extend that left arm over. And this is our willow pose. And back hand center. And release. Go ahead and shake that out a bit. And I will meet you on the left side. So get comfortable wherever you can. And hands heart center. Feel free to stay where you are or extend your branches out. And let's swing onto our left side. And back to your heart center. And release. Go ahead and shake that out a bit. Now we're gonna grab the outside of our right ankle with our right hand. And bring your hand up straight. Now we're just gonna tilt forward. As we tilt forward, our hand will go down, our foot will be going up, and go ahead slowly and peacefully into your dancer's pose. And relax. Go ahead and switch to your other side. Left hand to your left ankle. Right hand high and tilt forward. And hold. And relax. Go ahead and shake that out. And get a good old shake out. And let's go into our forward fold. Let's walk our hands forward and step back with our feet into our plank. Go ahead and relax those knees into your child's pose. Go ahead and lift yourself up onto your knees. And with your left hand, go ahead and extend up. And take your right hand and grab your heel or your ankle and extend back. And go ahead and switch sides. And go ahead and grab that right heel one more time. And one last switch off. Now let's go ahead and take a seat. Keep your left foot close. And bring your right foot on top. And just take a few moments to breathe right here. Now let's go ahead and walk our hands forward. I'm coming to you, so come to me. As far as you can go. Go ahead and stretch that left arm high to the sky. And back down. Bring that right hand high. And back down. Let's go ahead and bring our hands back. And let's switch feet. So bring your right foot close. Left on top. And breathe. Let's go ahead and walk forward with our hands. Extend that right arm up. And release. Let's bring our left arm up. And release. Go ahead and walk your hands back. And take a moment just to breathe once again. Now let's go ahead and kick our feet out and relax on our back in our Savasana pose. Go ahead and relax back. You can spread your feet the width of your mat. Go ahead and bring your palms up to the sky. And allow your body to just relax and breathe and appreciate the stillness of this moment. Let's focus on those deep inhales and those peaceful exhales. Focus on that breathing. In the beginning of our session today, I did mention my personal healing and wanting you guys to allow yoga to help you heal as well. But bigger than my healing and your healing, there are communities that need healing. There are communities still fighting for the peace and respect that Dr. King was fighting for. Let's all fill our minds and our hearts with love, compassion, understanding, kindness, and thoughts of peace for all people. Just allow your mind and your heart to fill with positive thoughts for communities that are going through struggles that aren't fair for anyone to be experiencing. And in these last few moments together, let's send major love vibes to Dr. King's family. Go ahead and wiggle those ankles, wiggle those toes, bring yourself back from that moment of stillness that we shared. Go ahead and lift those knees. I will meet you in our seated position. Thank you, as always, for taking some time for yourself today and for taking that time with me here in Memphis, Tennessee. I appreciate you guys all so much for always joining me as we explore new places together, dig deep and find healing for ourselves and for communities in general. Go ahead and bring your hands heart center. As always, I'm sending you guys a bunch of positive vibes for your week. Feel free to send me vibes back. Namaste. So I'm going to go ahead and pack up all my stuff, and I will see you guys inside the museum.
Turned into hashtags and prayer hands. I'm tired of watching these murderers get off while we bury the lost love. Innocent brothers and sisters, it's time to wake up, wake up, wake up. Brothers and sisters, it's time to say something, do something, make them. I wonder how many black lives, how many black lives, how many heartbeats turned into flat lines? Oh. How many black lives, how many black lives does it take to wake the change? Does it take to wake the change?
Through make a light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who have been seared in